How many of you here in the audience have at least once in your life gone through the pain of getting advice when you haven't asked for it? Okay, almost everyone. So, one of the things that is available in abundance in India and is given free is advice. So advice basically comes at all stages of your life from various sources and various forms. Today I want to talk to you about some of my life experiences and why I have stopped taking advice. When I was 15, which is almost 13 years ago, I was researching my career options. What are the professions that I could take up? So when I was in school, I realized that I wasn't very good at physics, chemistry, or biology. So I was sure I want to do something that has nothing to do with that. And while researching one of the professions that I found decently good and which also fitted my criteria, which was I was good in math. So I said, okay, I want to be a chartered accountant. So I informed my family the same thing, because one of the things is you have to always have an answer, especially when you're young. When people ask you, beta, aage kya karna hai? So I thought, okay, I finally found my answer. And I informed my family about the same thing. And they introduced me to a person who was pursuing their CA course so that I could get advice from them. Now, it was a long conversation with that person. But one of the things I remember which that person said was that bahut mushkil hai. It's very tough. It's very tough that many people quit midway. Right? And that was the advice I was getting from this person. So basically, my dream of becoming a CA had a very short life. And after that person said that, I just went blank. And by the end of that conversation, I completely quit the idea of even like trying becoming a CA. The funny part here is, after a few months, I got to know that this person who had given me advice quit his CA course in his final year. Because he himself wasn't able to enjoy it. He didn't enjoy it, he failed, or probably he quit for some other reason. But do you see what happened here? This person, who had no idea what he wanted to do, but he felt that he could provide his advice to someone like me, someone very young, who was trying to aspire to do something. This was the time when I realized how dangerous it can be to get advice, to blindly take advice from people. This is also the time when I started realizing the importance of listening to myself. So I started working when I was 20, soon after I completed my bachelor's. And in the last 8 years, I've worked in multiple companies doing different jobs. And every time I switched to a new company, I took up a job for a lesser salary than what I was making earlier. Now, before you think I'm crazy, let me explain. The reasons were that I was either moving to a smaller company, I was either working at a startup, or I was planning to work at an NGO, or I was taking up a lower level position because I felt that that opportunity was so much better than what I was doing at that point of time. Now, this is again our concept of what we have learned about how generally we should build our career and professional life. But I nevertheless took those decisions because I realized that at that point of time in my life, what mattered to me more was the learning and experience that I would gain from these opportunities. In 2015, when I was working at Facebook in California, I decided to quit my job to pursue one of my goals in life, which was to work on a social issue at a grassroots level. So I knew that this was a time again in life when I would start getting advice from family and friends about how I was being very foolish in leaving such an amazing job and coming back to India. So I was like, okay, what do I do now? Only after I quit my job. Because at that point of time, the only option they were left with was to feel pity for me, which in my opinion is so much better than advice being forced on you. After moving back to India and briefly working with an NGO in Lucknow, I started my own social project. So through this social project, I work with the youth in schools and colleges to create awareness on the issue of gender-based violence, which is one of the biggest social issues in our country. Gender-based violence includes crimes like rape, domestic violence, sexual harassment, stalking, eve-teasing, bullying, relationship abuse, and the list goes on. Through my workshops, I try to break the taboo on these topics and also on things like gender inequalities, the importance of consent, what masculinity means. In Hindi we call it mardangi. What does it actually mean? And also the different kinds of violence like physical, sexual, and psychological violence. Now, before I started this project, you know, theoretically everything in my head was perfect, that okay, I have to prepare the content, I have to go to schools, deliver this workshop. Because theories, it's always good, it's always easier, it's the easiest to sit on your sofa and make these decisions. But unless you're on the field, working with people and experiencing the real life, you will not know how hard life can hit you. So you won't imagine, even though all of this was done based on my savings, I did not charge a single rupee from the schools and colleges for most of my workshops. I thought, okay, what could go wrong? But I got my first workshop after approaching almost 20 schools. And overall till date, out of all the schools I've reached out to, more than 75% of them have rejected my proposals. Even though it's a free of cost workshop. The reason is because of our patriarchal mindsets. Most of the school authorities don't want these kind of workshops to happen in their schools because they think that their children are too young to get exposed to such content. Bolte hai ki hamare bacche to bahut masoom hain. Why are you going to spoil them with all of this information? Right? So I faced difficulties which I didn't imagine. But when you stick to what you believe, right, there are good things that will happen. So at the end of every workshop, I ask the participants to write down what is the one thing that they want to change in themselves based on what they have learned from the workshop. I'd like to share with you two letters which are really special to me, which hit me really hard and which told me that why even simple conversations can be very, very important. So both of these letters are written in Telugu, so I'll translate it for all of you in English. So the first letter, this is written by a 10th class boy, a boy studying in 10th class in a government school in Hyderabad. He wrote, "Sir, I have a girlfriend and there have been a lot of instances where I have touched her without her consent, even when she didn't like it. And when I was doing that, I didn't feel even a bit of guilt because I thought that I was a boyfriend and I was the man in this relationship and it's okay for me to do that, even if she says no. But during our conversations today, especially when you're talking about consent, and when you spoke about why respecting the other person's opinion is important, I realized how wrong I have been all this time." He said, "Sir, I promise you, going forward, I will never ever force myself onto someone, be it my girlfriend, be it my wife, and I will always respect the other person's opinion." The second letter is from another boy. He wrote that every day after school, he goes home, throws his bag, and at around 5:30, a bunch of friends and this guy, they meet up on a street, and for the next 2 hours, all they're doing is passing comments on girls and women walking by and stalking. He said that, "I did this because I thought this was the way to show my masculinity, especially among my friends. This is the way I'm going to prove my mardangi. This is how I'm going to become a man." And today when you're talking about all of the stalking cases, the acid attacks and all of such instances, I felt so bad because I was one of that persons that you were talking about. And I realized how wrong I was. So again, he again promised me. He said that today onwards, I will never even go there and I will also convince my friends. I will explain to them that this is not what masculinity is. I get hundreds of such letters. right? And when people ask me, what will a 2 hour conversation change? Right? Because our mindsets have grown like since the time we were children. What can change? I show them these letters, saying that when you have an open mind, even a simple conversation can bring about the biggest change in you. So when I look back at the decisions I had made during that time when I was in these confusions whether of doing this work or not, I realized that if I had listened to people who, by the way, did not have the experience of working on such things or, you know, working in other fields, if I had taken the advice just in the fear that I would fail, I would not have all of these experiences that made me and what I am today. And I wouldn't have moments like these to cherish for the rest of my life. What started as a workshop for 150 kids in a small classroom last year has now become a project through which I have reached out to 10,000 youth across the country. I'd like to share with you two things that I had to change in myself through which I became more self-aware, more confident, and I was able to build my own formula of success and happiness and how I want to lead my life. So we often hear that every change begins with learning. But I have realized that every change actually begins with unlearning. Was this concept of being selfless I had in my head, and also many people have this. I feel that selflessness is unnecessarily glorified. I'll tell you why. So when people come to me and I'm having conversations with them, one of the things they ask me is, how were you able to take up such selfless work? And I tell them, what are you talking about? I don't get what you're talking about. Because what I do, it is actually the most selfish thing I've done in my life. Even though I'm not getting wealthier in terms of money, I'm getting so much wealthier in terms of experience and the joy I get because of these workshops that I conduct with the kids, because of the joy I get from it. So I tell them that there is an extremely selfish motive behind doing this work, which is purely the joy I get out of it. So the first thing I had to be comfortable with was this concept of being selfish. There's a lot of negative connotation around this word selfish, but it's not bad. It is just a simple idea which says that the pursuit of your happiness and your self-interest needs to be first. It doesn't mean you stop caring about others. Because only when you are able to be selfish, take care of your priorities, take care of your self-interest, that is when you will be happy and others around you also will be more happier and others also will feel the impact of your work. And I've seen this personally happen with me as well, because since the time I've started prioritizing my work, my self-interest, my happiness, my relationship with my wife, my family, my friends has become a lot better. The second thing I had to unlearn was fearing failure. One of the reasons we often take advice, we're always looking for answers, is that we're just scared of failure. I was always scared of failure. When I look back at my school life, I missed out on so many opportunities that I didn't take up because I was scared of failing, I was scared of embarrassing myself in front of my friends and family. There are 7 billion of us on this planet, 7 billion, and each one of us is unique. Everyone, every single person is unique. And we are always looking at others to get to learn, to inspire. But we forget that each one of us has the potential to build a great story. So I redefined failure for myself. Redefining failure for the world, in fact, changing anything for the world is extremely tough, almost impossible. But you can do so much for yourself. So I redefined failure for myself. I said that one fine day, today onwards, for me personally, what failure means is not when I don't succeed at something, but when I want to do something and I haven't tried doing it. Simple as that. It is when I regret not doing something. That is failure for me. Now, I'd be lying if I said that I was completely fearless when I was in the process of making all these decisions in my life. You know, be it taking up jobs in fields that I had no experience in, or starting up a social project just by myself, putting in all my savings in a new city with no contacts, or be it one of the biggest decisions in life, which was when I eloped and got married with an amazing person, my wife who's sitting with me right here today, against the wishes of my entire family and community because we were in an inter-caste relationship. I was super scared when I was making all of these decisions. And when I think back that, okay, why did I make these decisions? I realized that what I feared more was not doing those things. I knew it could probably fail, but I feared more that I wouldn't try. So now what I fear more is the regret I would have 10, 20, 30 years down the line of not doing something. I don't want to live a life when 30 years down the line I say, I had an idea, I had a plan, I had an adventure that I could take up, but I didn't because I was scared that I would fail. So I redefined failure for myself. And I've made so many mistakes making these decisions by myself. I've taken up jobs which weren't right for me. I realized only after doing that. But through that, I learned what are my strengths, what are my weaknesses, what do I love doing, what I don't. I haven't taken care of money really well in the initial stages of my career. But through that, I've learned how to manage my finances better. So failure is amazing because you can learn a lot from it. When you're making decisions, you learn a lot from it. And what I've learned is that a bad decision is much better than no decision at all. Because even from a bad decision, you're learning something. But you're not taking a decision, or when you're relying on others' advice, you're not actually learning anything for yourself. Your idea is either going to be hit or a flop, but you're not learning anything. But when even it's your own failure, you can proudly say that this is my mistake. I had my own reasons for doing this. And you're not blaming anyone for the rest of the life. That's the best part. You're not blaming someone else. That I couldn't do this because my father said something. I couldn't do this because my mother said something. I couldn't do this because my friends discouraged me. It's all yours. I'd like to end by sharing one of my favorite quotes, which goes, "A ship in its harbor is safe, but that is not what ships are built for." Thank you.